Good morning, hello, welcome back to another video. Today we're at Magic Kingdom. Bit of a late start this morning. I didn't sleep very well, not last night, the night before, so Tuesday night. I was up really early Wednesday morning, so yesterday I was shattered. So after Epcot, Nathan, Craig, Mark, Rachel and Kane all went out to the bar down the boardwalk. And I went back to the resort because I was just so tired. So they went back, I literally got home, fell asleep, and then had about 11 and a half hours sleep and woke up about just after 9. The castle is pretty. But I'm just looking on Genie Plus to see what I can get. After my Haunted Mansion, I've got the Haunted Mansion, that's all booked, I'm about to go on that now. And then after that, I'll see what I can get. So I can't book another one now till after that, I don't believe. I'm gonna have a quick look. Yeah, 11:56. So it looks like it's gonna be a busy day here at Magic Kingdom today. Because this is currently the lightning lane queue to get into Haunted Mansion. I'm excited to try this because I've not done Haunted Mansion. I've not done anything here really. I have done it when I was a kid. But I know what Phantom Manor's like at Disneyland Paris, which is obviously their version of Haunted Mansion. So I'm excited to see what this is like and see what the difference is and actually have it in English as well. That's also going to help.
Gather close around the dying fire.
When hinges creak in Dora's chambers, Dora avoiding, almost as though you sense a disquieting metamorphosis. Is this haunted room actually stretching? Or is it your imagination? And consider this dismaying observation. This chamber has no windows and no doors. Which offers you this chilling challenge to find a way out. Of course, there's always my way. I didn't mean to frighten you prematurely. The real chills come later.
So Haunted Mansion was really good. Really, really good. It's better than Paris's Phantom Manor. I will say that again. But it took me by surprise, some of it. There's some bits that are similar, some bits that's completely different, which is great. So I really enjoyed it. It's classic. But also, it took me where the photo was. So I got all ready thinking the photo was of the grinning ghosts, but it's not. I've no idea where it is. So my picture, I'm like this, because I'm like just looking and watching everything, so I look miserable as sin, with my camera in front of me. But I will find it, no doubt I'll be going on it again. So I have got another lightning lane booked to meet me here at 4 o'clock. Which means I can book another one at just after 1 o'clock, because it'll be 2 hours then since I booked my last one. So I'm just heading back now into Tomorrowland to go on the Carousel of Progress and also get a pretzel and something to eat, I think, because I'm still peckish, I haven't had anything to eat yet. But yeah, it's a lovely, beautiful day. I've left my cap at home by mistake. So yeah, should be a beautiful day.
Welcome to Walt Disney's Carousel of Progress. For the courtesy of all other guests, we ask that you please remain seated for the entire show. Parents, please supervise your children. Children, please supervise your parents and enjoy the show.
Welcome to Walt Disney's Carousel of Progress. You're in for a real treat. The Carousel of Progress was Walt's own idea from beginning to end. He loved it. He introduced the show at the World's Fair in New York City in 1964, and it was an immediate smash hit. Millions of people came to see it. And since then, the Carousel of Progress has had more performances than any other stage show in the history of American theater. You know, Walt loved the idea of progress, and he loved the American family. And he himself was probably as American as anyone could possibly be. He thought it would be fun to watch the American family go through the 20th century, experiencing all the new wonders as they came. And he put them together in a show called Carousel of Progress, which we are now about to see. Although our Carousel family has experienced a few changes over the years, our show still revolves around the same theme, and that's progress. May the century begin.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away.
Looks like the robins are getting ready to celebrate Valentine's Day today. What year is it? Oh, right around the turn of the century. And believe me, things couldn't be any better than they are today. Yes, sir, buildings are towering now as high as 20 stories. And moving pictures flicker up on a big screen. We have almost 8,000 automobiles in this country, and we can travel by train from New York to California in less than 7 days. And I even hear tell about two brothers from North Carolina who are working on some kind of flying contraption. It'll never work. Closer to home, we've now got gas lamps, a telephone, and the latest design in cast iron stoves. And that reservoir keeps 5 gallons of water hot and just 3 buckets of coal. Oh, well, that sure beats chopping wood. And isn't our new ice box a beauty? Look at that. Holds 50 pounds of ice. Milk doesn't sour as quick as it used to. And our dog Rover here keeps the water in the drip pan from overflowing. It wasn't too long ago we had to carry water from a well. And thanks to progress, we've got a pump right here in the kitchen. Of course, we keep a bucket of water handy to prime it with. Yes, sir, we've got everything we need to make life easier. Say, Mother, I was reading about a fellow named Tom Edison who's working on an idea for snap-on electric lights.
Electric? No more kerosene, no more gas.
Sarah sure gets to the core of the apple.
But we do have this new wash day marvel. Now it takes me only 5 hours to do the wash. Imagine, it used to take 2 days.
Well, that's right, folks. Now Sarah has time for other things like
canning and cleaning the oven.
Yes, dear.
Well, ovens don't just clean themselves, you know.
I know, dear. And they probably never will.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got to get the laundry over. Before it starts raining cats and dogs.
Don't worry, Rover. She didn't mean real dogs. Besides, it's not going to rain today. My lumbago isn't acting up.
I'm not going to say I told you so.
Boy, you're going to come down. All you have to do is put your wash on the line, right? Oh, well, the cistern was low anyway.
My new boyfriend Theodore sees me in this. It'll scare him away.
Well, dear. If that happens, you'll always have that torch you can carry for him.
Oh, Father.
Calm down, Rover. I was only kidding. By the way, we have indoor plumbing now. Oh, boy, that's really great on cold nights, especially for our perennial house guest, old Uncle Orville. Uncle Orville's taken over the coolest spot in the house, of course, and he's rigged up a real clever contraption. He calls it air cooling. Too bad he's not reading the help wanted ads.
No privacy at all around this place.
Sorry, Orville. You know, considering all the... Oh, coming, Martha, as I was saying. Considering all the conveniences we now have, I'll say that we're really on Easy Street these days. It just can't get any better. Just goes to show that there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day.
Beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away. smiling at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away.
They said about me when I was dating Sarah. You're lucky, Rover. You don't have to date. Well, we're caught up in the do-it-yourself craze these days. We're remodeling our basement in something called a rumpus room, and we're looking forward to a few rumpuses, I'll tell you, as long as they don't get out of hand.
John, this papering is getting out of hand. Use a little help.
Now, Sarah, didn't I set up that clever automatic paint stirring machine for you?
Yes, John, you're a genius. Of course, this will ruin my food mixer. Not that you'd care.
Oh, good old Sarah. Always the last laugh.
Your turn, Grandma. Let's switch the image over to the TV so the resident flying ace can show you how it works. Now, it's a little tricky. Just use your game glove to fly behind the other guy and blast him with your laser blaster.
Laser blaster? Well, I'll give it a try.
Take a look around, Grandma. You're in the ship.
Feels like I'm really there.
Okay, get ready. You're about to blast off.
Here goes nothing. Whoa.
All right, here it comes. Oh, you missed him.
Hey, everybody. I'm done programming our new voice activation system.
Now all our household items will do anything we tell them to do.
Great. Tell the refrigerator to bring me a root beer.
Well, it can't quite do that. But I'll show you something it can do. Tree lights 30% brighter.
Oh, that's no big deal. Anybody can do that voice activated stuff. Watch this. Rover, feet.
John, the oven should respond to your voice commands now. Give it a try.
Oh, okay. Here goes. Temperature to 375.
Temperature increase to 375.
Look at that. It even talks back.
Reminds me of certain people I know.
Yeah, right, Dad.
You gotta Dad, Grandma's up to 550 points.
Did you say 550? Hey, she's getting the hang of that thing.
I can't believe all the new gadgets they've got now. You know, in my day.
Oh, no. You're not going to tell us about the old days when you didn't even have a car phone.
Hey, Trish, for a while we didn't even have a house phone. Not to mention laser discs, high-def TV, everything is automated today, including that.
Wow, 975.
Temperature increase to 975. Big mode, overload, command, error.
John, what's wrong with the oven?
What,
Big mode complete. Enjoy your meal.
Anyone for pizza?
Oh, another Christmas turkey ruined. Man, what a game. I really smoked those guys. Looks like I'm resident flying ace now.
Oh, best 2 out of 3, Grandma.
Later, kid. Boy, that's fun. What will they think of next?
Who knows? We've got a whole new century waiting for us out there.
Yeah, and maybe sometime in the new century, your mother will learn how to talk to our oven.
Well, maybe by then ovens will read our minds. But hey, as long as we're all here and happy and together for the holidays, who cares if I burned our Christmas turkey?
I do. I'm starving.
Don't worry, Dad. Someday everything's going to be so automated, you won't ever have to cook another Christmas turkey again.
So it's a great big beautiful tomorrow, standing at the end of every day. It's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away. Such a good attraction. I forgot how good it was. I could happily go and sit on it again, to be honest. But I'm heading out of Tomorrowland for a bit now. Gonna go down Main Street, have a look down some of the shops, and then by that time I should be able to get another Genie Plus reservation for the next one. Might have a look inside the castle as well, actually, because I haven't done that yet. So yeah, I need to probably buy a cap from somewhere, because I've left both of mine at the resort. and it's getting quite warm now. So, yeah. So fuck it. Oh, I just still can't believe I'm here, to be honest. I really can't. Oh look, it's Winnie the Pooh and friends. So I've just had a shop around the Emporium and had a look. The Dapper Dans are out. But I bought myself a hat. It's $40. Did I need it? Yes. I forgot to bring one with me and it's very hot, so I definitely did need it. I couldn't have gone for a slightly cheaper one. I definitely needed the lounge fly on. So yeah, I have 10 more minutes so I can book a Lightning Lane now, so just going to start heading back down Main Street. Really good. I wasn't, yeah, I love shows. And how regular they are is really good as well.